Hello, praise the Lord Jesus Christ. I'd like to thank God so much for giving us an opportunity also to share from the Bible. And we've been talking about the foundational teachings or the teachings of the apostles. These are the teachings that Paul laid out to the church, and they are supposed to be a greater foundation that will lead us to perfection. It's God's intention to perfect us. It's God's intention to make us, especially the church, to be who He wants us to be. And that is to be like Jesus. He desires that when He shall be coming back, we will be like Him. So this moment we will be talking about the resurrection of the dead, the resurrection of the dead. And I remember the beginning I told us that there are six elementary teachings that Paul gave to the church. The first one of all was repentance from dead works. Then we had faith towards God. Number three, the doctrine of baptisms. Four, laying on of hands. And now number five is resurrection of the dead. Resurrection of the dead is one of the greatest pillars that as believers we need to embrace, and not only embracing, but put our whole hope in it. Because God has given us several years to live in this earth. Some of us might live for 50 years, some 20, some even 2 days, some 70 years, some 100, and even 120. But then after that, if Jesus will not come back when we're still alive, in one way or another we're going to die. Today as I'm speaking this, there's a lot of people who are dying of corona. And many people are fearing corona so much, unlike the way they fear Jesus. But God is so much interested in our faith. God is so much interested on what we are believing in, on whom we are believing in. Because in one way or another, we are going to die. The way we're going to die is not a problem. We might die of corona, we might die of accident, we might die of disease, or some of us, we can even die when we're sleeping, meaning we might not even feel that we're going to die. But the biggest question is, after death, where are you going to go? Because in one way or another, we're going to die. Today we might be suffering, you might be very sick, or you might be in Mary, you might be very happy, because there are a lot of things that God has given to you. But one of the things that is very sure to us, if Jesus will not come and meet us, we will die. But then when we die, where are we going to go? Where are we going to spend eternity? Are we going to arise? Are we going to be like the Indians say, you're going to be born a cow, or you're going to be born a cat, or you're going to be born a goat, or you're going to be born in a rich family? Us as Christians, we believe that when we die, Christ shall resurrect us, just like the way He went in Martha's home. And as Martha was lamenting and Mary was also lamenting, if Jesus you were here, our brother would not have died. Jesus told them, no, because I'm here, I am the resurrection. What did they say? We know He's going to arise one day. But Jesus told them, no, it's not one day, but today, because I am the resurrection and the life. Even the oldest book of the Bible, the book of Job, clearly shows that there's resurrection. From the olden times, people believed in resurrection. And do you know what? As a church, God has called us. God wants us to understand that one day when we die, one day when this body of sicknesses, one day when this body that is full of lust, this body that is full of failures, when it shall go down, there's a day that comes whereby we are going to be raised. You're not going to go for good. Some people say, no, as long as I'm dead, everything is gone. We will be resurrected, either to live eternal life or to live for eternal judgment. I want us to read and understand that. It's found in 1 Corinthians chapter 15. 1 Corinthians chapter 15 from verse 12. The Bible says, now if Christ is proclaimed as raised from the dead, how can some of you say that there is no resurrection of the dead? Then not even Christ has been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, then our preaching is in vain and your faith is in vain. We are even found to be misrepresenting God because we testified about God that he raised Christ, whom he did not raise, if it is true that the dead are not raised. For if the dead are not raised, not even Christ has been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile and you are still in your sins. Then those who have fallen asleep in Christ have perished. If in Christ we have hope, in this life only, we are of all people most to be pitied. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruit of those who have fallen asleep. For us, by a man came death, by a man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, so also in Christ shall all be made alive. Why is it that I'm saying this resurrection after life, after death? It is because Christ died, and he is the firstborn of them that are dying in him. Is the firstborn. He showed it that we are going to be raised. Do you know that when he died after 3 days, God raised him? And the Bible says, by the Spirit of the living God, he raised him up. And this clearly shows us that when we die in him, we are going to be raised. And we will be raised to receive eternal receive eternal life, not eternal judgment. The world will receive eternal judgment. Them that didn't know him, they are going to receive eternal judgment. For us that we know him, we are going to receive eternal life. There's some people were saying that, no, we're just believing anything. Some people are saying, no, we don't believe in resurrection. We believe in Jesus, but we don't believe in resurrection. If there was no resurrection, Christianity will not exist. Today, as we are talking, all the other prophets are dead. Moses is dead. Samuel is dead. John is dead. But only Jesus Christ is alive. He conquered death. He conquered it and gave us victory. All the other prophets, like Muhammad, they are dead. They are still in their graves. Them that studied Confucius, they are all dead. But Jesus Christ is alive. And that proves to us that one day when our lives will be ended in this world, we are going to be live with him. Verse 35 of 1 Corinthians, it says, but some will ask, how are the dead raised? With what kind of body do they come? Paul says, you foolish person, what you sow does not come to life unless it dies. And what you sow is not the body that is to be, but a bare kernel, perhaps of wheat or some other grain. But God gives it a body as he has chosen, and to each kind of seed has its own body. For not all flesh is the same, but there is one kind for humans, another for animals, another for birds, another for fish. There are heavenly bodies and earthly bodies, but the glory of the heavenly is of one kind, and the glory of the earthly is of another. There is one glory of the sun, and another glory of the moon, and another glory of the stars, for the star differs from star in glory. So is it with the resurrection of the dead. What is sown is perishable, what is raised is imperishable. It is sown in dishonor, it is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, it is raised in power. It is sown in natural body, it is raised in spiritual body. If there is a natural body, there is also a spiritual body. If you have been asking yourself, when I die and I be raised, what type of body am I going to have? It is the body of resurrection. It is the body that has the presence and the power of God. It is the body that doesn't understand what lust is. It is a body that overcomes every sin. It is a body that is victorious. Just like when we die, our bodies seems to be useless. But then when we have that new body, it will be a body full of power. And that is why the Bible here says we will be raised in glory. Although we die in dishonor, but we'll be raised in glory. We'll have a spiritual body. Some people are asking, what is a spiritual body? the spiritual body, it will be like the body of Jesus Christ. We shall have a different body, a body that overcomes everything in this world. Do you know that death came by this man called Adam? But then through second Adam, that is Jesus Christ, we are going to have a new body. And it is my desire that all of us, you that is watching me, when we will be raised, you shall have this body, the body of the Son of God, the body that overcomes everything, the body that is victorious. We will not understand sickness again. We will not understand failures again. We will not understand pity again, because we will be given a new body, the body of the Spirit. Verse 46 says, but it is not the spiritual that is first, but the natural, and then the spiritual. The first man was from the earth, a man of dust. The second man is from heaven, as was the man of the dust. So also are those who are of the dust. And as it is the man of heaven, so are those who are of heaven. Just as we have borne the image of the man of dust, we shall also bear the image of the man of heaven. So if you've not received Jesus Christ, if you've not believed in him, you have a problem. Because when you will be raised, you will not have the body like his. You will have the body that is going to go to judgment. It is my prayer to you, because we've been given some few years, and in Psalms we teach us to number our days so that we might gain a heart of wisdom. When we understand that after we've spent 1 year, it means the years that God had given us, it has reduced by 1 year. We need to gain wisdom. We need to live a life that is pleasing before him, so that we will be in the we will be assured of life after death. Verse 50, as I'm winding up, I tell you this, brothers, flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable. Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we shall be changed. For this perishable body must put on the imperishable, and this mortal body must put on immortality. When the perishable puts on the imperishable, and the mortal puts on the immortality, then shall come to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brothers, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. Brothers and sisters, wherever you are, I know we have one great enemy, and that great enemy is death. Every one of us are fighting. If we were told death is coming from this door, I know all of us are going to hide. But do you know what? We have the victory through Jesus Christ. We have the victory because of what he did on the cross, because of him being buried and arising from the dead. He gave us the victory from death. And when we have died, we will be raised with a different body, a body that will never die again. That is the greatest hope that we have, that we will never die again. And do you know what? There are some people who will not die. They will not experience the death. But then, even if they don't die, their bodies will need to be changed. And that is the greatest reason as to why we need to incline ourselves well with the Lord. We need to accept him. We need to believe him. Because when we believe in him, our bodies are going to be changed. And we're going to live a victorious life. We're going to be righteous. We are going to be pleasing before the presence of the Lord. May God richly bless you as you abound in love, as you become steadfast, immovable in your faith, as you continue abounding, doing the work of the Lord. God has called you to serve him. And how do you serve him? By proclaiming who he is. How do you serve him? By testifying of his greatness, by testifying of his goodness. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord remember you. And every labor that you've been doing, every work that you've been doing, every function that you've been operating in, may the Lord remember you. And may you remember that all your work are never in vain. It is never in vain. Even when you'll be in the grave, it shall never be in vain, because the Lord is going to raise you. And after raising you, is going to reward you for the greatest work that you've done. As I wonder, I want you to remember this resurrection of the dead. That is a pillar and one of the teachings that apostles gave to the church. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, I want to thank you because you're reminding us that our years, that our days are numbered in this world. And after our days, and after we have breathed the last, O God Almighty, we are very sure that we are going to be raised. Just like the way Lazarus was raised, we shall be raised. We shall live in a glorious body. We shall live in a glorious body. We shall be like you, Jesus Christ. I want to thank you because every day, as you remind us, O God, that this is the greatest hope that we have, our faith in your Son, our faith in a man that is able to raise us, our faith in a man that is able to make us righteous. Thank you, King of Glory. Thank you, Jesus Christ, because we have hope above hope. Thank you because we have faith above faith, that God Almighty, our faith is in you. Our hope is in you, Jesus. We give you all the glory and honor. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. May God bless you so much. Remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.